better get. Oh shit. There is a fee.
Is there?
Do you have cash? I have none.
None. My wallet's in my bag though.
I have a card. Hold on.
Okay. Take card.
Ask him if he takes card.
How you doing?
Hey there.
Hey, do you guys take cards?
We do indeed. Is it going to be two adults?
Two adults, yes, please.
Okay.
And two pugs.
All
right.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Pass for you.
All right, thank you. Pugs are free, I guess.
Okay, just put this on your pass. You're all set. Thanks, y'all.
Thanks,
thank
sir.
You.
Appreciate it.
Yeah. Thank you. That is why it's convenient to have your credit card in your phone case.
Typically, it's kind of important.
Could you please roll the window? Okay, so we are in Paris Mountain State Park. It's a state park in the U.S. state of South Carolina, located 5 miles north of Greenville. Activities available in the 1,540-acre park include hiking, biking, swimming, and picnicking. And as you see, it was a $6 charge per person. They do take credit cards, so yay. Now, within the park, there is a 13-acre Lake Placid, which offers swimming and fishing. Canoes, kayaks, and pedal boats are seasonally available for rental. Private boats are not permitted. Camping is allowed, and campsites range from rustic backcountry sites to paved sites with water and electricity hookups. The park's Civilian Conservation Corps structures include the Camp Buckhorn Lodge, are listed on the National Register of Historic Places. Little bit of history, Cherokee Indians once dwelled on Paris Mountain before European men began to colonize North America. The first white man settled in what is known as Greenville County in 1765. He was an Irishman from Virginia named Richard Paris. He married a Cherokee woman and became close to the Cherokee tribe. The Indians continually gave Paris land until the property extended 10 square miles. Richard Paris is the source of the name Paris Mountain. In 1775, a letter from the Superintendent of Indian Affairs, Jonathan Stewart, was written to the Cherokee Indians chastising the Indians for selling their lands to white men. In one part of the letter, Stewart writes, "You are consistently listening to Richard Paris, who cheats you out of your lands. Some of the land which Richard Paris possessed contained the mountain known today as Paris Mountain. Therefore, the name Paris is a construed form of Paris, which is spelled P-E-A-R-I-S. A legend surrounding the mountain speaks of the first white men to visit the mountain. The chief of the indwelling Cherokee tribe tried to protect the mountain, and when he grew old, he passed on the responsibility to his daughter and her husband. The husband failed in the task and sold the mountain. In anger, the daughter of the chief killed her husband." So those are my fun facts. That is part of Wikipedia's page, so that's where I found that out. Now, in the state park here, there are several different trails that you can go on. They have different difficulty levels. Today we will be going on Sulphur Springs, which is a difficulty of 8, and then going on Canoga, number 6. So we'll be there in just a second.